Hello, my name is György Hajnal. I am Professor of Public Policy and Management at Corvinus University of Budapest, Head of Department and Academic Director of the Master Program in Public Policy and Management. Throughout their careers, students, experts, professionals, practitioners are expected to write large amounts of text, studies, reports. We are starting to learn and to teach this in the bachelor and master levels, but actually even before that in the primary and secondary schools. And these learning processes continue in the doctoral training and in our professional careers as well. Despite the huge efforts and loads of feedback received from peers, reviewers and other colleagues, there are a surprisingly large number of typical mistakes. We very frequently come across poorly formulated sentences, paragraphs, sections and even entire papers. With some extent of simplification, I could say that my experience that I gained in this regard over the past more than 20 years as a researcher and professor in public policy and public administration is more or less consistent with Leo Tolstoy's famous quote, "All happy families are alike, but each unhappy family is different in its own way." That is, most good papers are similar, but problematic ones are problematic in diverse and highly individual ways. Despite the apparent heterogeneity of these failures and errors, this can be distilled into a relatively small number of typical ones. These are actually not so much errors in wording or expression that relate to an inadequate mastery of a foreign language, such as, for example, English. Rather, these problems are related to the logic and consistency and clarity of thinking and expression. Quite perversely, many of these failures actually stem from our school and everyday experiences, because the notions of how we express ourselves in everyday parlance differ systematically from the rules and conventions of academic or professional expression, especially in writing. One of the courses I am teaching therefore relates not so much how to write a good paper, because it is very easy to formulate these principles and the general rules, but it's very difficult to follow them, follow these rules, even for more experienced researchers. Rather, I usually start this course with teaching my students how to write a bad paper. So let's take a look at a few examples of typical mistakes I'm coming over and over when writing student and researcher's theses and dissertations and other types of written materials. The kind of in medias res starting of a paper is frequently a very good way of grabbing attention in everyday parlance and also in literary writing. However, in academic context, we need to give a detailed justification of why we are targeting this particular issue, why it is important, and how do we want to contribute to the ongoing academic discourse in the given field. Another typical mistake is when there is no question, no puzzle in a paper. I frequently read passages in beginnings of essays like, "In this study I will analyze this and that." Unfortunately, however, this is not a question. It doesn't tell us why this study is going to be educative or informative. How does it contribute to our understanding or our practice in the given field? A third typical set of mistakes, I have to say, is that one of the major and standard elements of the written piece is missing. For example, method. We tend to disregard the boring details in everyday parlance. Even in an interview situation, frequently we jump to the conclusions and recommendations because that's what is important for the reader and the listener. However, in academic pieces, it's very important to be explicit about the logic and the evidence on which our claims are based. Another mistake is when there is a huge and obvious discrepancy between the analysis and findings on the one hand and conclusions we arrive at on the other. There are different subtypes within this type. For example, the answer we give to the research question is actually an answer to something else, not the research question in itself. Or our answer is not based on the analysis and findings we produced in the research, but rather they reflect our preconceptions. These mistakes are more related to the logic underlying our essay. However, there are also important problems with the ways we express our thoughts. In a written piece of text, the logic, the flow of text should be transparent and clear. And actually, it has to be easily recognizable for the reader. So, how can we, so to say, avoid this? For example, we can have text blocks with unclear function. We can have a section title and then write about the given topic without giving any clear idea to the reader how this topic relates to the overall ambition of the piece. How does it fit to the overall logic? Another way to do this is to create a discrepancy between the titles of text units and the content. So, for example, we promise to write about the method, but we start to do something else, such as reviewing the theoretical problems of the field. A third way to create ambiguity is to use ambiguous metaphors or frequently too high or improperly chosen level of abstraction in our text. Frequently we do this in a quite unnoticed way. We use metaphors actually much more frequently than we think we do. The problem here is that the real meaning of these metaphors is very much up to interpretation, and even our own interpretation is quite ambiguous in many instances. Finally, the best way maybe to create ambiguity in a text is to create a lack of recognizable logical connection between text parts. This can appear within sentences, between sentence parts, between consecutive sentences, or even between subsequent larger text units.